must be equal to the minimum when V, the element of K, like this, of the half of A, of also V, V, minus 5V. Look at this condition, by this one. So the fact that if you are in this condition, where A is symmetric, this condition, the characteristic that you here, by the two of U and K, and you have this condition. I said that this kind of relation is very useful for solving some linear differential equation. Like we could say the elliptic linear partial differential equation, you use this kind of property to prove the essence of the solution and so on. Maybe you will come after to, you will come back to Yale to study this kind of property. For the proof of this one, you need a lemon. For the proof of this one, the theorem of Stampatio. You need a lemma like this. You need this lemma, which is called the thing called Banach fixed point. This one. You say that let X be a metric space, a complete metric space. I'll change my marker. I'll take another better one. Complete metric space like this. I take this kind of function and X a map to this one from X into X like this from here. Such that you have this condition. I'll try to, yeah. Say that you have the distance, it's metric space, so you have this distance, or maybe this distance can put in D, like something like that. Say that the distance of X, F1, and X, F2, maybe less than K, the distance of F1, F2, like this, where K is just less than 1, and F, X, two elements of this one, F, one, F, two elements of X. If we are this in a condition, there exists, then there exists U in your X, such that you have it on SU. It's not the way to go into the term. U is a fixed point by your map defining on this metric space. Okay, from here you need this one to prove the spontaneous the theorem you previously defined. Okay. Now I will not give you the proof of this one. The proof you can get it everywhere. So I'll give you a corollary of this the theorem of spontaneous, which will be very useful also. This corollary says that instead of taking H, K, like this, K in like a convex subset you take, you just suppose that you are in the same condition. You have a corollary. Like this one. You are in this condition. A is also continuous. It's continuous. Is cohesive and bilinear form. Okay, I will change my marker potato. Maybe I change this. Linear form like this, bilinear form. And for all five, you take in the H, the dual of H, they resist also. this one, you with the element of H, such that you have this condition, such that you have this A and U, V like this, is like this kind of function, yeah. Such that you have A, V, 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 minus, minus V equal to phi of V. If you have to do here, and it's be better. A V U, V U, this must be equal to this one, the scalar root of U, of V, this one. Yeah, this kind of one. For all V, element of your X, this one. You need this, the part of you want to pull to pull it. So instead of reading like this, I know U V is better, UV, it's better. UV is not symmetric, and so both UV and you have these conditions here for all V in V. Yeah, so, and this one. This one also is equivalent to the second condition. When the case, when A is symmetric, you have the same condition. When A is symmetric, you have you can put also what we told you that you here, which you got in 8 years, is also characterized by the same condition you got previously, using that the fact that you have a u the half of a u minus phi u might be defined by a half of the minimum of this one. The same you get it the same thing when this one is symmetric. This one is very simple. You can use it, you can prove it, I can prove it for you. And how we can deduce this relation from the previous one. How can deduce this one from the previous relation you got to this? Before you say that for the first one, you say that there exists the value U in H in K like this. When for all five you take in the dual of this one, there's a U which is a unit. And inside that you have A U V minus U must be equal to five V minus U. If you want to have, you have to go previously. So I'll change my marker to have a better marker for you. I don't know if I get another one. It's important. Okay. So you have this condition. How we can pull from here and to have this one. So I will change this one. And the red one, you don't know it's better, but okay, you try to do it. How can they get this one? You just you don't put by V. In our case, your H, your U is made of H, which is a vector space. This one is also in vector space, this one. In our case here, V is vector space. V is the element of this, which is the Hilbert space. Then for all T in R, T, V is also in this vector space, in the Hilbert space also. Then you can get the same relation from the previous one. Then you have this one is also true. U K V minus U equal to the square for this one K V minus U. You have this one. And from here, that means that what you have what? Then you have A minus U V like this. U minus U KV, if you can put KV here, KV minus, you can put upside here, phi of U, you can put it of U like this, of KV like this, okay, KV like this, but I'm going to do, I'll change the form of this one. You need to have this kind of form. I too, I can put the form like this one and put it again outside to get the same function which we are get outside. So this one, they get A like this. UKV like this. Okay, also, you want to get this kind of form. So minus phi KV like this. This not must be equal to A U like this, and the same form which you get there plus this one minus phi and U. You get this form, and this one is linear also. You can put out KK here. I can put out KK here. Then from here, you have A from U V minus phi V like this. Must be equal to 1 over k of this condition, this one. When if we take k tend to infinity, when k tend to infinity like this, this one will be tend to 0, then you have your relation with it. Simply with it. When you take k tend to infinity, this one tend to 0, then you have your relation. It's just equivalent of the previous theorem, this passage of theorem. Okay, thanks.